Now, while most of us are looking forward to spending the festive season with friends and family, for many, Christmas and New Year's is the hardest part of the year. It's important to remember you are not alone, and joining us now is the chair of Lifeline, John Brogden. John, thank you so much for joining us today. It really is a pleasure to speak to you. You're expecting the next few weeks to be amongst the busiest in Lifeline's history.
Yeah, well, it's quite interesting. Last year, of course, we'd finished 2 years of COVID and bushfires. This year we've had floods, we've had all the uncertainty of 3 years of natural disasters, and of course none of us have ever lived through anything like COVID. And now we're looking into an economically difficult time. We're being told there'll be a recession next year, interest rates have gone up and they'll probably keep going up, people are coming off fixed term mortgages. So as human beings, we look for a few things in life. One of them is to love somebody and to be loved, but the other thing is certainty. So a lot of people are going into this Christmas New Year period uncertain. Others are lonely. Not all of us have a big Christmas Day lunch or dinner or whatever it might be. And for some people, this is the first Christmas after Dad died or Mum died or an emotional thing happened to them. So for many people, for most of us, it's a really happy and exciting day. For many people, it's quite a lonely and troubling day.
John, how can we support those that are struggling? Because people that are generally struggling, they generally lash out and they, you know, like they sometimes... it's a very personal thing to my heart. They sometimes lash out and self-destruct and want to isolate themselves. And you watch that happen and you...
Breaks your heart.
It completely breaks your heart. I'm so sorry. It just completely breaks your heart.
Yeah.
And there is a very... They ask to be left alone or whatever. In this moment at Christmas, you see these emotions happening to so many people around you. What's the right thing to do for those people?
Well, I had a very difficult time growing up. We had domestic violence in the household and alcoholism. And for me, in my first years of marriage, Christmas was the worst day of the year for me. And I know that feeling you talk about of being isolated. I didn't want to see anybody. In fact, 1 year we just went to Fiji because we got away from everybody. The thing that changed it for me was having kids and watching them be so excited about Christmas.
Yeah.
But I think the most important thing is... sometimes you can be lonely in plain sight. You can be at a Christmas lunch. You can be very involved and be miserable. And others mightn't understand why. You understand why, because you live with somebody who has a difficult time, right?
Yeah.
So I think the most important thing to understand is it's okay not to be okay. You don't have to fit the stereotype of being excited and all of that sort of stuff.
Yeah.
There are a few other guides. One of them is there's never any good outcome to getting written off on Christmas Day.
Yeah.
So it's not a good day to do that. Because of all the emotion that can be associated with. In terms of that support, you know, I like this time of the year because I ring, I sometimes text, but I ring people I don't see often. And for many people, that phone call on Christmas Day, that catch up maybe once a year, can make their day and can fill the hole of that loneliness. But it can be a difficult time for many. And it's okay not to be okay. It's okay if it's been a difficult year with a loss of a loved one to feel grief when everybody is feeling happy. And give people space. Exactly what you said. Give people space because for not everybody, this is a great day. It can be quite a difficult day. But we can make a difference. For those of us who are going to have a good day, seriously, ringing somebody, you can always squeeze another person in the table on Christmas Day, even a couple of days beforehand. You're thinking of somebody and you think, actually, they're going to have a tough time. Let's put another table, seat around the table. There's always enough turkey or ham or whatever it might be to go one extra person. And you just can't underestimate the difference that makes. And I really encourage people to ring, not just to text or do the social media thing. That helps, but to break through and have a conversation with them. And I'll tell you what, you can save people's lives. It's a very busy time for us. But the busiest time in the almost 60 years of Lifeline's history, we're 60 years old in March next year, the busiest time ever was New Year's Day this year, over 4,000 calls on one day. And I think it's because people woke up from 2021 moving into 2022. And remember, we still had COVID. We've still got COVID now. We still had uncertainty. And the horizon was quite unclear for people. So out of the blue, our numbers went right up for a day and came down because I think people got out of bed hoping for an exciting new year, but they were mugged by the reality of a difficult year ahead. And I think next year is going to be even more challenging for the reasons we discussed earlier, interest rates, home loans, the price of things. Have you filled up your car recently?
Oh, yeah. Yeah. Tell me about it, yeah.
It's like working on the soul, isn't it? Like, if you say, I'm going to feel better at this date because you get to that date and you feel quite lonely and lost because you were banking on that date, but it's working within you.
It's the two sides of that hope,
isn't
it? And one is great, of course, and one is kind of just destructive as well. So as part of these kind of the 12 days of wellness, you talk a lot about setting positive boundaries.
Yes.
How exactly can we do it, and what do you mean by that?
Well, I think it's important to realise that it could be a challenging day for you. So I think part of the challenge is we're very socialised to be happy. Mm. You know, this is the happy day. And if you're miserable, you feel really out of sorts and you need to set your boundaries that it is going to be a difficult day. And hopefully the people around you will know that as well, rather than slapping you on the back and expecting you to be as excited as they are. It's important to make time for that grief as well. So it's really setting your own expectations of what sort of day it's going to be for you and not pushing over them, not thinking, well, the way through this is to drink a lot of grog. The way through this is to maybe not get out of bed all day. So it's a case of meeting your own expectations in the middle, and that's quite important. Setting a budget's quite important. My mother, you weren't here, I'm assuming you're in Ireland, but my mother had the ritual cutting of the bank card, remember the old bank card? When the bill came in January, the ritual cutting the bank card. And then next January she had the ritual cutting the bank card.
Or you freeze it in the freezer, you put it in the block.
I didn't know that one. That's a great one.
Just ripped the bills.
Move to Australia.
That's right, change your personality, change your name. But that was because she didn't set a realistic budget. So she crashed out of Christmas into this big debt. So manage your budget, that's quite important. Don't come out of Christmas, New Year with a big debt.
Yes.
Manage your expectations of the year to come. That's quite important as well. And as I said before, you know, if you're lonely, there are always people there, whether it's Lifeline on 13, 11, 14 or whether it's a friend, but we can make a difference by reaching out. Don't sit there thinking, what do I do? You don't have to be a psychologist, a psychiatrist, a counsellor. Just a phone call. Dad's 90 next year and he makes a couple of phone calls to relatives that he only makes once a year and maybe the odd old mate. And he arrives at lunch, you know, really quite boosted by the fact that he's caught up and, you know, what's happening in your life and all those sorts of things. But he has the sadness at his age. Of course, there are a few less mates this year because they're all that age. But, you know, it's also looking for a few happy things that make you very happy and make you feel comfortable. Just search those out and we can make a difference. Don't think we're sitting at home not able to make that small amount of difference, because we can.
The power of human relationships. Oh, my goodness.
Exactly.
It's worth more than any money in the world.
And the power of the voice, you know, the power of that voice contact back and forth. I can't tell you how much it cuts through what can be a very difficult day for people. And listen, as always, listen to people and hear what their sadness might be on this day and let them know it's okay to feel sad.
And people need to hear that.
Yes.
And you guys do absolutely great work. Thank you so much for coming
into
us today. And just make sure you remember, Lifeline is always available 24 hours a day, 7 days a week and right through the holidays on 13, 11, 14. John, thanks so much for joining us today.
Thanks,
appreciate
guys.
It.